This morning, we want to share with you two scriptures. We're going to begin first in the letter of 1 John, the second chapter. Despite what the bulletin says, we changed our mind and we're imposing on the Boy Scouts. You thought they were getting a shorter reading. We're going to be having them read from the second chapter, beginning at the first verse through the 14th verse. Listen carefully for what John is saying about love and loving God and what it means. Following the children's moment, we're going to turn to the gospel reading, the gospel recorded by Matthew. It's again part of the Sermon on the Mount, and so we begin with the beginning of that message where Jesus goes off the mountain and assumes the place of the teacher and sits down. So we'll be reading from Matthew 5, verses 1 and 2, and then skipping over to verse 38 through 48. These are some of the heart sayings of Jesus, and some of the things that Jesus is saying to us that just don't sound normal. But listen carefully for what the instructions are, how it is that we are to behave, how it is that we are to show forth God's love. Before we turn to the scriptures, let us again turn to our God. Let us seek a sense of understanding. Shall we pray? Almighty God, we have come into your presence. We've gathered here in the sanctuary to offer our prayers and our praises, to sing the hymns to you. But Lord, we have also come to have a personal experience with you. We've come to hear your voice. And so, Lord, we pray that by the power of your Holy Spirit, you would touch the heart and the lips and the mind of those who are to read. Touch the heart and the mind and the soul of those who are to preach. Touch each of us. Touch our ears, that we might hear. Touch our hearts, that we might accept. Touch our minds, that we might know. Touch our hands, that we might do. All the things that you're calling us to do, through the reading of these scriptures and the proclamation of your word. Help us, O Lord, to live into the scripture and be the people you call us to be. Lord, we ask in the name of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anyone does sin, we have an advocate with us, with the Father, Jesus Christ, the righteous. And he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. And not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. Now by this we may be sure that we know him. If we obey his commandments, whoever says, I have come to know him, but does not obey his commandments, is a liar. And in such a person, the truth does not exist. But whoever obeys his word, truly in this person, the love of God has reached perfection. By this we may be sure that we are in him. Whoever says, I abide in him, ought to walk just as he walked. Beloved, I am writing to you, no new commandment, but an old commandment that you had from the beginning. The old commandment is the word that you have heard. Yet I am writing you a new commandment that is true in him and in you, because the darkness is passing away, and the true light is already shining. Whoever says, I am in the light, while hating a brother or sister, is in the darkness. Whoever loses a brother or sister lives in the light. And in such a person, there is no cause for stumbling. But whoever hates another being, beloved, is in the darkness, walks in the darkness, and does not know the way to go. Because the darkness has brought on blindness, I am writing to you, little children, because your sins are forgiven on account of his name. I am writing to you, fathers, because we know him who is from the beginning. I am writing to you, young people, because you have conquered the evil one. I am writing to you, children, because you know the Father. I write to you, fathers, because you know him who is from the beginning. I write to you, young people, because you are strong, and the word of God abides in you, and you have overcome the evil one, the word of God.